Cyborg for $20 says, awesome, Mauler is on. Now I can bolster his consistency position. Adam, when you are writing a movie, conflict is necessary, but what makes it good is whether the conflict is consistent with the themes and characters in it.
Oh,
you've created a monster, Mauler. I don't I just like, I'm watching that first episode of The House of Dragon, and I mean, I'm going, boy, there's a lot of consistency in here that's really got me interested.
That's the funny thing, right? You'd probably describe traits of characters and how they influence certain decisions, and I'd be like, Adam, well, you're describing consistency right there.
First of all, I've never said like you should go for inconsistency in your movie. Like, that's just a bastardization of my position. Like, I'm saying that, you know, there's a hierarchy of values in movie making, and I would place conflict at the top of that hierarchy. Obviously, we have a disagreement there, but consistency is definitely in the hierarchy. Obviously, you can't make a movie that's inconsistent and still have a good movie. So, but conflict, I just like all the stuff we were talking about that first episode. I mean, it's just fucking, they throw so much conflict at you in that first episode. You're like, oh my God. And it's as human beings, it's fun to play that game of, oh my God, what would I do in this, you know, two unthinkable options situation. I mean, yeah.
To be fair, Adam, there's a lot of conflict in the first episode of Rings of Power.
What? Ridiculous.
I could go through it if you want. All the instances of Sitch, how do you feel about this argument before I make it? Like, what do you think is going to happen? Like,
is there conflict in the first episode? I mean, there is conflict. It's just not interesting conflict.
There you go. That's what I think. I think there's plenty of conflict. It's just all shit.
Well, I mean, obviously.
But wait a minute. It doesn't. That's not the issue. I mean, they still has to have conflict, like as a base.
Well, and also what you're saying is there's no stakes to the conflict, and stakes are obviously part of the hierarchy.
Right.
Well, I don't know how much you want to spend on this, but obviously I think consistency powers any individual thing you think is important. I think consistency is behind it.
Well, consistency may be an element of it. Sure. I mean, I fully agree with that.
Well, to me, this conversation is weird because I don't think you can put like consistency and conflict on a seesaw and say like which one's more important.
I don't think they have to.
I think all these elements of story have to kind of work together to produce a good story. Obviously, it's hard for me to think of a story, a movie or a TV show that's like horribly inconsistent and that I think is good. But it's also hard for me to imagine a story or movie that has like no conflict or weak conflict that is good. Right. So I think they go hand in hand with each other.
I think that if you're writing things to be consistent, it's almost impossible to avoid conflict.
What the problem though with Rings of Power is there isn't real stakes, and we don't even really understand the stakes. Like in the Nori story with the Harfoot, we don't know anything that's going on. How can we be invested in the fucking stakes of the story? I don't know the stakes. I don't know who this old guy is. I don't know what he's supposed to be doing. I don't, like, there's no stakes in Nori's situation. Like, her dad, the ancillary character, is the one with the most stakes because he might fucking die because he's getting gangrene of the foot. But they haven't made us care about that character in any way, shape, or form. We're supposed to be watching Nori's story, and we don't even know what Nori's story is.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even, that's not how I criticize the Nori storyline. I think they've made it abundantly clear what his story is, and it's embarrassingly bad. Like, they keep telling us over and over again that the Harfoots never go off trail. And then she's like, but I'm going to go off trail.
That song is so bad.
And then we have like.
But compare that to the stakes in the House of the Dragon. Like, the doctors come to him, spoiler alert, the doctors come to him and basically say, you know, your wife is probably not going to live, but we could probably cut the baby out and, you know, maybe the baby will live. We don't know if it's a boy or a girl. You've wanted a boy up until now. So, like, there's a million, so, like, that's such a difficult decision. That's such a conflict-ridden decision. And they've created the stakes behind it being, like, the
stakes in Rings of Power is the rise of Sauron and all the orcs, and like you got
individual
stories.
Nori can go live in the woods somewhere. Like, what the like?
Also, the stakes for Nori's story is that she doesn't want the stranger to be found by a village because she worries that they would consider him an outsider and fucking do something to him. I don't know.
What could they do? But he's 10 times bigger than them. Right? Yeah,
that's kind of what I would be critical of. That's what I'm saying. But like, to be fair to the show, this is the thing. I would be critical of all these things in different ways. Like the elf guy's story. It's like there's a whole village that's been wiped out by an army of orcs that are coming for the villages he protects, and that they got a wider plan that we're going to have to figure out. It's like the stakes are all clear there. I think that we've not been informed enough as to who any of these people are. Nobody's reacting to these situations in ways that I think represent like humanity at all.
Which is terrible writing.
The girl. Yeah, this is what I mean. Like, I would focus more so on their inconsistent behaviors and the absolute lack of information that I think actually draws into inconsistencies again in terms of like understanding how this world comes together. How did the orcs manage to stay secret? Have you seen the shot of where they're digging? They fucking dug themselves into that tree. It was hilarious.
How do stakes touch on inconsistency? And again, Mauler, I don't want to attack you here. I feel like
it's all good.
I agree. Consistency is paramount. Like if you have a movie that's inconsistent, character inconsistency is the worst. When you spend a bunch of time building up a character that people understand and, you know, are interested in, and then all of a sudden that character does something completely out of character, that would be inconsistent and could destroy the movie, could eviscerate the movie. If you have a situation where you have very high stakes that have been built up, for instance, you know, the guy in the house of the dragon wants a son so badly, okay? Like, if all of a sudden the kid is cut out and the kid lives and it's a girl and he's like, oh, okay, well, fuck it. I didn't want a son that bad anyway. You'd be like, what happened here? Like, you would blame inconsistency. It completely eviscerated the stakes of the show. So I do understand your argument, what you're saying here. I just think all of that, I think consistency serves these other things, and it's these other things that are the reason people enjoy movies.
I'm more than happy to concede nobody comes out of the cinema going, man, I loved how much that just made so much sense. But I actually think that's the underlying thing that gets them to enjoy it without them realizing it.
Right. Yes, of course. Well, consistency, things have to be consistent because otherwise you go, oh, I'm watching a movie.
Yes, it completely breaks,
right?
Breaks the willing suspension of disbelief and you're like, this movie sucks. I hate
it. To give you an example, Adam, of what I just described being something that sometimes I've done because I've gotten so like hyper autistic with analyzing stuff sometimes. When Stranger Things was coming out, did either of you guys? Yeah, I know, right? Did either of you guys watch Stranger Things season 4?
I have not watched Stranger Things.
So like they released it, I think there was 9 episodes. They did 7 at once and then 2 later because it was like a finale 2 episodes. I think that's how it was anyway. We knew there was a character who was like a metalhead, and there's a clip that's really quick in the trailer for the last 2 episodes where he's playing a song, and me and friends were just like, from everything we'd seen up to that point, it's like, what would that song be? And we just pulled together from all the different things that have been happening in the show, who the villain is, what like the arc that character's going on, what bands he's interested in, what era from the show it's based on. And we had like a couple of songs in mind, but the main one that I was hoping it was being, you can catch streams where I'm talking to Gary about how I'm really desperate for it to be this.
Oh no.
Like hopefully it's Master of Puppets from, well.
And they blew it.
No, it was. It was Master of Puppets. Oh, okay.
You called it.
I wasn't the only one that called it. Plenty of other people had picked up from, some people had guessed it from the way he was playing the fucking guitar in the 2-second clip. It was amazing. But I can't remember what stream it was. I was trying to explain all of my reasons for why I think that that would be the perfect choice, like thematically, character-wise, in the world, in the timeline.
Right.
And they did it. And I can honestly tell you that I'm not just enjoying it because I'm a fucking metalhead and I love that song when I was in that scene. I was fucking high off how much that made sense.
But didn't they just set it up right? Couldn't they have picked the song first and then built the story around setting up that song correctly?
Yeah,
there's a couple of options you can take, and as long as it lines up in some way, shape, or form to some degree, I think it's like worth praising. But if it just spits on everything you understand to be the case, then yeah, I'd be complaining.
Well, I don't think modern writers think of setup and payoff. Even I think it's like
some of them do here and there. Even Stranger Things season 4 has plenty of writing problems.
Right.
They do it in House of the Dragon. I mean, it's all setup, payoff.
To maybe build a bridge between conflict and consistency. There was there's something, an issue in the third episode of Rings of Power I had, which is that, you know, when Artie wakes up in the orc slave camp, mm-hmm. and he sees that all the other elves who were stationed at the watchtower have also been captured and enslaved by the orcs. And I was like, what? Like, that's the dumbest fucking thing that they ever could have possibly done. Like the orcs. And I can believe that the orcs are stupid, but I'm assuming that whoever's controlling them, Adar, if that's Sorin or whoever, is intelligent. Why would they capture the group of elves who, if they don't show up back in Elftown, they'll send a search party to go find them and say, oh, there's a bunch of orcs digging a giant tunnel starting to try to take over this area of the country. Like, that was so insane to me that they would capture them. When if they hadn't captured them, if they were intelligent, they let them just go return back home. No one fucking knows what the orcs are doing over in Mordor. Yeah,
which, by the way, Sitch, makes you realize, wait a minute, so the attack wasn't organized to simply happen once the watchtower was abandoned?
Yeah, it's just a coincidence. Right, it's just a coincidence. And then on top of that, it would add extra stakes to our main character, Artie, because then when he's trying to escape, it's not just because he wants to like escape. It's he needs to warn and get the elves to know that there's all this shit going down.
Yeah. Yeah, no, you're right. This is my issue with all of it. None of it makes any fucking sense.
Yeah.
Yep. Cyborg for $20 says, Adam, everything you would say is necessary for writing a good movie. You need to be consistent. Consistency is the foundation of all these things you would claim are needed for a story. Cyborg's really like pushing.
Dude, hey, Mahler, how do you feel
hey,
about
this? Hey, someone's calling out my credentials for metal in chat. What? If you ask what his favorite metal bands are, so funnily enough, someone in chat probably already knows this. My favorite metal bands are Rhapsody of Fire, Avantasia, and right now Powerwolf.
I had no idea you
hey,
were Sitch into
Adam.
Though,
either
which
of
is
you recognize
cool.
either of those,
kind
any of those bands?
No, I don't know any of those bands. Are these new
However,
metal bands?
That's the thing. Most people don't even know. So the idea that I only like mainstream ones is pretty retarded. But out of the mainstream ones, my favorite is Iron Maiden, which you guys would have heard of.
Of course, I'm aware.
I love.
Or what
Iron
kind of
Maiden.
What kind of metal? Or is that like power metal that you like?
I like. Yeah, my favorite is power and symphonic metal.
What's your favorite genres. Iron Maiden album?
Brave New World.
Okay, is that new?
Well, it was new when I first heard it back in the day. I remember when it was new.
Well, I love Peace of Mind, and Peace of Mind is probably older than
I mean, this is the thing that I don't think there's really a wrong choice, at least when you pick
Peace,
the
a Peace of Mind is like amazing, but anyway. I didn't know you were into metal, so
nice.
New lore.
Everyone's always surprised by it.
New
Mahler lore.
It is kind of funny, but I like it. Yeah.
I remember in high school I like Dragon Force. In terms of power metal, mm-hmm. all their nerdy power metal songs.
I like some of Dragon Force's songs. Yeah, they're right.
that's the real nerd music. Okay.
I just the whole thing. Cyborg, what are you trying to accomplish?
Oh wait, sorry.
Here? Like, are you trying to This is the thing. Like, if you want to say consistency is more important to me than conflict, you knock yourself out. Where it's a little troublesome is when you're arguing that conflict is not important in movies, because I feel like it's you against the world.
I don't think this is an argument worth having.
No,
because it sort of doesn't make sense.
Yeah,
because I think you need both of these elements.
Yes,
to function properly as a story.
Yes, yeah.
But
yes, that's why. I mean. I'm comfortable. Like I said, I'm a consistency guy. I'm down with consistency. Please put consistency in your movie.
Mm-hmm.
So.